Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustubh here, and as per the title guys, in this video I will be telling you my thoughts as well as some of the top features of this ROM, which is the Lineage OS 17.1. and this is a nightly build guys, and it is based upon Android 10. So in this video we will be looking at that ROM. Also guys, before starting the video, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn on the notifications so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. So without wasting any further time, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So this is the phone which I'm using. This is the Oneplus 3T, and right now I flashed the LineageOS 17.1 custom ROM on top of it, and I will just quickly show you the about info of the ROM itself. So in this, as we can see, the current Android version is Android version 10, so that's what we get, and this is a cool logo which I really like about Android 10. Then the next thing on the list is the LineageOS version, which is clearly written here, it is 17.1 nightly build for the Oneplus 3. So what nightly means is that you will get daily updates, like in 3 to 4 days interval time you will get daily updates so that the ROM becomes more stable and usable. So if you again tap on it, you will get this original LineageOS logo, which looks really full, really great, and really with some popping colors on the background. So yeah, so that's a quite cool animation. Next thing is the patch level, Android security patch level. So here we are getting the 5th June patch, which is really great. So it is the latest update from Google, so that's what the developer is providing with the ROM. Other than that, the Google Play system update version is 10, as well as if we take a look at the kernel, then we are getting the latest kernel, which is the LineageOS kernel itself, which is 3.18.124. So guys, if you are using this ROM, just don't mess with the kernel, let it be. If we talk about the customization that its ROM provides, then there are a bare minimum of customizations that are available. So if we firstly go into the display, here we get the dark theme option. So the complete system UI will go into dark mode basically. Then the next thing in the display is this live display feature, which has a couple of color profiles which you can choose. I prefer using dynamic right here, and also there are some color calibration as well as picture adjustment settings present. Then the next thing is this is what the specialty is about LineageOS. We get some basic customizations. So here, as you can see, there are a couple of styles. So I've set this custom style here. If I go into the edit option here, I can change the font to whatever I want. I have this 4 options, from that only I could select. So I'm selecting this font. Then also the icons can be changed, so I'm keeping it to this. The accent color can also be changed. There are not a lot of accent colors, but it's okay, like it has at least some of them. And these are the icon shapes. This also can be changed to whatever you want. I'm keeping this squeeze circle ones, and here is a custom name you can put on to the style. So I have applied the custom style, and guys, this is how it looks. Now the icon just squeeze circle, and also the quick setting tiles, they have been also modified as per the set design. So that's there. Again, I will also show you another thing in settings is if we go into the system option here, we get this buttons. So in this, we can select the on-screen navigation bar. So that's still present on this ROM. Other than that, these are the navigation bar customization features. Power button, here we get end call feature, long press for touch, which is explanatory, self-explanatory. Then in home button, we get this answer call option. Resend buttons also, we have a couple of customization options present. And in volume buttons also, it can be customized, especially like this one. This is the control playback. So just by pressing the volume button, you can forward or reverse the track. That's also there. As well as by default guys, it is coming to this left side, and if I have turned on this left side option, if I close it, then it will come to the right side. So that's also a handy feature. I prefer it to the left. If we take a look in this battery section, then I've been using it about for 4 days. This ROM I've been using for about 4 days right now, and I was average getting about 2.5 to 3 hours of SOT. So it is not that great. If you compare it with any other stable ROM, that is, if I compare it with a CRDroid Android 9 based ROM, then I was getting around 4 to 4.5 hours of SOT, whereas on this ROM I'm getting about 3 hours of SOT. So that is a downside of this ROM. Other than that, in this battery section, we get a battery manager which auto detects and optimizes your battery use, as well as we have this power profiles in the battery options. Next thing, guys, is the camera performance of this ROM. By default, guys, it comes with this app. This is the AOSP camera app, and it is quite shitty, I should say. Like, it has very basic UI with very basic features, I should say. So I don't prefer using this. Rather, I'm using this gcam mod, which is present for the OnePlus 3T, and it just works wonder. So if you are using this ROM, just install a gcam mod and you will be good with the camera department also. Second last thing on the list, guys, is the launcher itself. By default, it comes with this stock launcher, which is the Trebuchet launcher. So it doesn't has any a lot of customization options in it. So if we go in this home settings, we have this allow edits, that is to move the icons, then add icon to home screen. All these options are pretty self-explanatory, I will not go into detail. So this is the stock launcher which it comes with, and by default, guys, the animations are a bit slow. So right now, if you can see, the phone is working really fast and fluid. That's because, guys, I have changed the animation settings in the developer options. So, guys, finally concluding the video, what I would suggest is that all this Android 10 ROMs that have come out recently, they are not that stable, at least in the case of OnePlus 3T. So I would not suggest you to daily drive an Android 10 based ROM. Rather, you can go for a CRDroid or Android Pie ROM, which I've made a video card might pop right here. So you can check that ROM also if you want a daily driver stability, as well as complete customization features as well. So it has a lot of customization too. So that is also what something is missing. Customizations are not that there, but I get it, because this is a stock Android ROM. It is just pure vanilla Android, and it works really well. I should say it is pure Android. So yeah, so this is my review and my thoughts. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, guys, and also please do get subscribed to my channel for more upcoming content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.